How did you do that?
Whoa!
Holy
cow!
Oh boy.
All you have to do is ask.
Hey guys, how y'all doing out there? It's time for another tutorial from Pinnacle Studio Pro. As you can see, I had a toot request to do the Flash Quicksilver thing, so I had to bring it to my peeps real quick and fast in a hurry. Pinnacle Studio Pro style, let's get into it. First off, you need a tripod when you do this, alright? Even if you're going to have everything all in frame, or if you're going to go from scene to scene. What I mean by that is, if you're going to have everything all in frame, make sure you start your run, then record some space where nothing's going on, and then record yourself going to the next position. Alright, if you're going from scene to scene, do the same thing. Record yourself in the scene, then record yourself out of the scene with all the other people still in it, and then do a recording of everyone else in the scene, and then yourself arriving in the scene. Basically, there has to be space in between your leaving and arriving with you not being in the scene, all right? So, now that we got all that done, let's talk about these clips. So originally, this was one clip, and all I really did was split the clips. I'm not gonna show you how to split clips because you know how to do that already. If you don't, I'll just give you a quick and brief understanding of it, okay? So, first thing you wanna do is have yourself moving to the first position. Then you want to bring your playhead to a place right where the person takes off. So as you can see, I'm right in the middle of starting to run, and then I split my clip here. All right. So if I move to that position, you'll see now on the next clip, there's nothing in this scene. So this is a scene that I recorded with nothing in it so that I could transition from one place to the other. Then I split my clip again. And I found myself a position where I was stopping at the next spot. And then I went to the beginning of that clip where I was stopping. Right before I got to my stop, I'm kind of transitioning into a stop. I split my clip there. Now you use the razor blade to split clips. And then to get the clips out of the way, after you split the clips, there'll be a clip in the middle. You will need to click on the trash bin to remove any clips that you do not want as part of the scene. All right. So let's talk about this middle clip where nothing's going on. So in this middle clip, I want it to be really, really fast. So I'm going to right click on it. I'm going to go to adjust duration. And I want mine to be about a half a second. Since my project is set at 30 frames per second, 15 frames is half a second. So you can see I have it at 0.15, 15 frames. All right. So I'm going to click OK. And I'm good to go there. Now you can also do more speeding and jumping and running around like I did, but let's just concentrate on these three clips here. All right. So I started, I had my gets open background, and then I came back in. So now what I need to do is create some way to transition to the next frame and make it look like I'm moving really fast. Now, because Pinnacle does not have masking where I can mask out the shape exactly as I want, what I did was I created a PNG image, which is a photo that is a .png file format, and I created myself, and I blurred that. So, I'm going to put my playhead to a position. I'm going to use my step back one frame to get a position where I'm on the screen. At this position, I'm going to click on Snapshot. What that'll do is it'll take a snapshot of this frame, and it'll be a JPEG. That's a different file of a picture. It'll be a JPEG picture, and I'm going to take that and make my adjustments in Photoshop. Now, if you don't know where the snapshots go to, here's how you can find out. Go to Setup, Control Panel, Import. Now, if you go down here to Snapshot Directory, it'll tell you the location on your computer where any snapshot you take with Pinnacle Studio is saved to. Just put your mouse over it and you can see that mine's in G, Photos, Pinnacle Snapshots. This is a location that I created, all right? Yours will say something different. It'll tell you which drive it's on. It'll tell you the name of the location and the folder that it's in, all right? Now, once you know that, go to that location on your computer and open up that photo in the photo editor of your choice. I'm going to use Adobe Photoshop CS6. So I already have the image in Photoshop. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna zoom in on this. I'm gonna hit Control and the plus sign to zoom this in. Now I'm gonna pick the quick selection tool here. If it's not already set on quick select, you could just hold your left mouse down and it'll let you pick a different one and you can pick quick select from there. And now I'm gonna go over here to this clip and I'm gonna right click on this background and I'm gonna do duplicate layer. I'm gonna call this layer mask this layer. So I know this is the one I'm masking. And now I'm going to hide the background by just clicking on the little eyeball here. Now I'm already set on the quick selection tool, but if you're not, you know where to go. So I'm just gonna hold my left mouse down and I'm gonna start dragging this out and letting it select pieces that I want. Now keep in mind, you don't have to be perfect with this, and the reason why is because it's gonna be all blurry in a second anyway. If you make a mistake like that, just hit the Alt key and then hold the left mouse down and it'll let you fix any mistakes you make. All right, now I'm gonna let go of Alt and I'm gonna finish bringing this out. I'm gonna hold Alt down again to get rid of this, get rid of that, get rid of this middle in here. Like I said, I don't have to be perfect, but I do want it to look good, at least kind of good. All right, I'm good. Yeah, not really. All right, that's good enough for me, my friends. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the little mask tool down here. It says add layer mask. I'm going to click on that and boom, background's gone. Doesn't look as good as I want it to look, though. Even though it's going to be blurry, I still want to make sure it looks right. You know, at least a little bit better than that with all the jagged edges. So I'm going to hit on mask edge up here to refine my mask. I'm gonna click on smart radius. Turn the radius up a little bit so I can see the jaggedness and what it's gonna fix. I'm gonna hit smooth to smooth that out. And that's a lot better. So I'll click OK. And now I'll just do file, save as. And I'm going to select PNG. Then I could just change the name to whatever I want to and hit save. I'll hit OK. And I'm done with that. So as you can see, we're back in Pinnacle. And in Pinnacle, I already have all my mask made that I wanted to use. So this is the first start blur because I named it first start blur. So I'm going to bring it down into the timeline. I'm going to put it right where I disappear off the screen. Now, as you can see, now instead of me just disappearing, boom, I got that little mask of myself there. So it looks good. So first thing I want to do is right click on this. I want to go to Open Effects Editor. I'm going to go to Camera. And I'm going to go to Blur. I'm going to go to Blur Amount. I'm going to change the vertical to 0. And change the horizontal to 32. If you want more blur or less blur, you can make it however you like. I'm gonna click OK. Now, of course, this is too long. I don't want the blur lasting the whole time. I just want the blur to kind of go on and off the screen. So I'm gonna right click on this blur picture and go to adjust duration. I want it to be really fast, so I'm gonna change this to 0.2, so it's basically just 2 frames. Click OK. And now you'll see if I play this, boom, you run into a blur. All right, so now I need to do the same thing for the other half. So you always put your picture right after or right before the person comes on the screen. At the start, you have it right after he leaves. So at the end, we need to have it right before he comes onto the screen. All right. So I'm gonna bring down my first stop blur. I'm gonna bring it right to this position right where the split happens, but I'm gonna move two frames back. One, two, and I'm gonna put a marker here because I wanna be able to move this two frames before he comes onto the screen. All right. So now I'm gonna right click on this and do adjust duration. And I'm also gonna change this one to two frames, 0, 2. And I'm gonna click okay. All right, so now we got that in place. Now, instead of doing the whole thing over again with the blur stuff, I'm just gonna spread out my timeline here so that I can see the effect. I'm gonna put my mouse up here until I see FX. Then I'm gonna right click on that, go to effect, do copy all. I'm gonna left click on this other little photo, right click on it and do paste. And now the effect is on that one as well. So now if I play this back, you'll see it. Boom, boom. Real fast, real quick, real beautiful. How you like, man? Nah. It's a wrap. The Flash or Quicksilver effect in Pinnacle Studio 17 Ultimate. All right, peeps, I got a bit of news to tell you. I got a new YouTube channel, all right? It's giving you YouTube tips, tutorials, tips, and everything on YouTube. It's called San Antonio YouTubers. Check it out, all right? Subscribe to our sister channel so you can get a lot of tips on how to make yourself a better YouTuber, make better videos, get more views, get more subscribers, collab with other people, all that good stuff. You're gonna freaking love it. Subscribe to San Antonio YouTubers, all right? Now back to this. You guys know the routine at the end of these videos. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction. Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comments. You know I love it when you leave me comments, all right? If you got questions, I'll try to help you. If I can't help you, I'll point you in the right direction and get you the help you need. And last, but definitely not least, don't you ever forget to subscribe, baby. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon. We'll be right back.